Hello students, in this session we will learn about earthing and its type. Earthing means connecting all the electrical equipments to the earth. In the earlier lecture we understood about the earth fault. That is when a live wire touches the electrical casing of the appliance, it generally leads to the electrocution or the shock to the user. So in order to avoid such electrocution and safety of the person, the user, we provide earthing, which helps to forward the current to the earth. So what are the uses of earthing? To safeguard users by preventing electric shocks, by preventing the leakage, excessive current flow in the circuit. Second, to prevent damage to the electrical appliances by preventing excessive current from current flow in the current. Thus, it prevents the excessive current flow in the circuit. Third, it prevents the risk of fire caused by short circuit, that is the current leakage. As we have seen in the fires in the building, in that topic also we have learned that short circuits is one of the prime reason for the fires. And when there is short circuit, it surely leads to the fire. And to avoid the fire, we need earthing. To maintain the voltage in the system, because there is a fluctuation. So to have a constant voltage, we use earthing, thus safeguarding overall system and overall all the appliances. So what are the types of earthing? Types of earthing are plate earthing, pipe earthing, rod earthing, and the fourth is maintenance free earthing. The IS code for this is IS 3043 1987. It guides you completely about the earthing and the specifications. All the numbers, digits and the details are given in this IS code. Let's see what is plate earthing. Firstly, dig a hole of at least 3 meter, depth of 3 meter. Then plate earthing uses a plate made of copper or galvanized iron. The plate of size 60 cm by 60 cm by 3.8 mm is placed at least 3 meter below the ground level. Then the plate is then connected to the copper wire to divert the electric current to the earth. Fill the pit with the mixture of layers of charcoal and salt to flush the pit with the ground level. First, we put the copper plate or the galvanized plate at the bottom of the 3 meter deep pit. Then we connect it with the copper wire. Take out the copper wire up to the earth level. Then fill up the remaining pit with the mixture or the alternate layers of your charcoal and salt to take it up to the level. Then, to maintain the moisture in the pit, we pour the water because we want minimum resistance to the flow of current. As there is minimum resistance to flow of current, there will be maximum flow of current. So resistance and the flow of current are inversely proportional. So how the figure goes? First, pit is dug. This is the ground level. Okay. Then go 3 meter at least deep. Then take a earthing copper plate, somewhat like this plate is taken. Then it is also filled here. It is filled with the charcoal and salt mixture. Then we, if it is possible, what we do, we provide a pipe or a funnel like structure to continuously pour water for 12 months a year. That is maintaining the maximum earthing level. And there we connect a copper wire of, or the connection, here it goes deep down to the your plate. This wire may also be insulated with an casing pipe. So it is a standard practice that to protect the copper wire with the casing, that if in order to avoid any contact or random contact by the user. So this funnel is used to insert the water to maintain the moisture throughout here, as it will help for keeping the moisture and thus the lowering the resistance, thus for maximum protection. Then the cast iron cover is kept over this. So it is changing with person to person or side to side. This is in standard nomenclature, like to dig up to minimum 3 meters deep, then place a copper plate or a galvanized plate. Depending upon the type of plate, the dimensions will be changing. Fill up it with the charcoal and salt mixture. Keep it sound enough. Here the lower layer should also be there of the mixture, then the copper plate, then again the complete mixture. And it will be better enough if we fill all these layer with the mixture. The funnel can additionally be provided, else we can keep it as like, means generally people keep it like that, but it is better to have a funnel to keep the moisture throughout intake, especially in the summers. So this was the plate earthing. Now the pipe earthing, same procedure is there. Dig up it at least 3 meter below the ground level. Then the pipe earthing uses a pipe of galvanized steel in the soil instead of the plate. So instead of the plate, we just need to insert the pipe vertically downwards. The pipe is drilled with the holes for connecting the earthing wire. The pipe is drilled at the point to connect it with the wire. The dimensions of the pipe depend on the type of soil and the type of electrical installation. So this can be consulted from the IS code. Any standard procedure or any standard can be opted for that. The pipe should be placed at least 3 meter below the earth. In this method, the earth pit are filled with the alternate layers of charcoal and salt for inducing reactivity. Pipe earthing is the most common type of earthing. So instead of plate, the common type is your pipe earthing. So this is same, dig a pit here. So digging up the pit downwards, fixing a pipe. Here it is necessary to have such kind of holes. So that is it. Wire is connected to here like this. It will be coming out here. Same again, funnel is inside here. The connections are laid down here. So we can have a like this connection through here also. From here, the wire can be connected here also, and these holes can be left as it is. So fill up this wire, this all the pipe with the material of your charcoal and your salt. Again, we will flush with the ground level and cover it up, maintain the moisture throughout the year. This is your simple working of the pipe earthing system. In the rod earthing system, everything is same. Dig a hole, then insert a rod here instead of the pipe. Again, connect it with the copper wire, and again flush it up with the system with the ground level, and maintain the moisture. That's it. Here we are using the copper wire because it has the maximum conductivity, so we are using copper wire. It's best to use the copper wire. So rod earthing is similar to pipe earthing, just by replacing the pipe with the rod. Just connect the rod with the wire and connect it with the system in the house. That's it. So the working is same. Now the fourth type of earthing is maintenance-free earthing. Everything, the three types of earthing what we have seen, it needs maintenance. That is, we need to keep right the connection of the wire and the rod plate or the pipe and the moisture content needs to be maintained. Also, after some specific duration, it needs to be charged again. That is, the charcoal gets also mixed and continuous moisture maintaining, that is watering the pit, leads for the salt to get rinsed off. So it needs a regular maintenance, but the maintenance free earthing is a product, is a system which has some minimum or say just zero maintenance. So let's see what it is. It is a efficient version of earthing. Dig a pit of set dimension, wet the wall of the pits, then prepare the compound as defined and pour it in the dug, in the dig. Here the companies who are constructing or who are producing these products, they provide you with the electrodes, that is the rod here. For now, just say it is a rod, kind of a rod. They provide with the compound, that is the filling material which needs to be filled into the pit, and just you need to insert the items. Dig a pit, insert a layer of the compound by mixing it with the said amount of water, layer it up, place an electrode, fill the remaining place with the compound and flush it up with the ground level. That's it. Cover the pit with the lid and flush it with the ground level. There is no maintenance and it has a long life. So zero maintenance, maximum output and a user friendly item. So if we see the dimensions, these dimensions and all are given in the product brochure. You can consult it and just get it done. So a small layer of a compound is placed here like this. Then the electrode is placed. Then the remaining part of your pit is filled up with the compound. So, and cover it with some protective cover. Terminal plate is there here. Just take out your wire and connect it to the load. That is your system. That's it. So what we learned that what is earthing? Earthing is, in a simple words, it is connecting all the appliances to the earth. Why? Because to overcome the earth fault. And what are earth fault? That is when a live wire, if in case touches the metallic part of your appliance, it may lead to shock to the user. So in order to avoid the shock, the return current or the current which has get into the appliance body, to remove it, we connect it with the earthing or the earth, and this process is known as earthing. So what are the uses of earthing? To protect the device, to protect the system, to protect the user, and to avoid the risk of fire in the building. Types of earthing are plate, uses the plate, the pipe earthing, rod earthing. So all these three types of earthing has somewhat same procedure. Dimensions will be varying. To brief it, dig a hole, put the item, a plate, a pipe or rod, fill it up, connect it with the copper wire, fill it with the layers or the mixtures of your charcoal and salt, maintain the moisture, and it is ready to use. Maintenance is necessary. Moisture need to be kept, especially in the summers. And on the other part is the maintenance free earthing. Buy a product from the market, dig a pit, pour a compound, place an electrode, fill up the dig with the pit with the remaining compound, and thus you can have a maintenance free earthing. So this was all about the earthing uses, types and the benefits of those earthing. That's it for now. Thank you.